Guys, and welcome to Uni Life. My name's Martine.
And my name's Connor. And today we'll be talking to you about coming to study at Birmingham City University.
Later on, we will be answering questions from the public. So please do tweet on Twitter, hashtag Uni Life.
So guys, introduce yourselves and tell us your group names.
Yes, my name is Patrick. I'm actually a student here at BCU. And
I'm Ash, bartender and student at BCU.
Okay.
And we are called Maroon 2, because we're both two people wearing maroon.
Lovely.
Hi, I'm Jans. I'm a student here at BCU.
Hi, I'm Rosie. I'm also a student here at BCU, and we're cookies and cream.
Ooh.
Hi, I'm Ewis. I'm a student here at BCU, studying media.
I'm Mohammed. I'm a student at BCU, studying media as well. And we're called Geronimo.
Like, actually started into my dissertation, yeah, so life's good for like 5 minutes. Yeah, it's just kind of busy and a bit fun.
All right, so for now you're not pulling your hair out of your head, it's all...
No, not yet. Oh.
Mad. No.
Mad?
Mad. It's good. It's nice.
Okay, it's nice.
You just got to like manage time and that and like make sure that it's all organised and you're all on top of it. Like.
Yeah, there's a lot of things to do as well for students, so you can get involved with anything that you want. We have our own graduate programme as well to be able to help those who are just coming into the university and make their own reality.
Stressful and occasionally a bit empty if you let it. I know in my first year a lot of people I knew in my flat and accommodation just sort of went to lectures and then were bored a lot of the time. But if you organise things and look at societies and organise things with other people, then it becomes a lot more fun and a lot less stressful if you have things organised and do things with people.
So you know, that's a tip that you guys should be listening to. Right here.
Student is such an exciting lifestyle, and Birmingham is a great city to live in while studying. We've got so many opinions and events there that people love. What about you, Connor?
The only responsibilities you really have here is experiencing new things and immersing yourself in new opportunities and making great memories with new friends and remembering that uni is here to better your future.
Completely agree. Take it as a time to learn, grow and become the best of you.
And where better place to do that than the second largest city in the UK, and that has opportunities around every corner.
They auditioned in their thousands. But tonight, one will be crowned the winner of Students in Their Eyes 2018. It's time to face the Students! We're live from Birmingham. This is the Students in Their Eyes Christmas finale. Martine Dennis.
All of my family are going to be there, so it's quite nerve-wracking.
How do you think your rehearsals are going?
Really good. Everyone's been getting together and we've all just been enjoying ourselves. My voice is a little tired, but I'm ready for the show.
Have you got any nerves towards the show, or do you feel...
Well, all of my family are going to be there, so it's quite nerve-wracking. A lot of pressure, but as long as they enjoy themselves, then yeah, hopefully everyone has a good night.
Uni has given me so many opportunities that has made me learn about myself and about what I want from life and about my goals that I want to succeed. All the freedom just allows you to be whoever you want to be.
Better watch out, you better not cry, you better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. Is coming to town. He's making a list, he's checking it twice. He's gonna find out who's naughty or nice. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town.
Guys here in the studio, just how did we enjoy that one? And Martine, it's as if you're an absolute professional. How did you find that one?
That was brilliant. I danced all the way through. It was amazing. I feel really good.
Yeah? Well, let's see what the judges think. Judges, how'd Martin do tonight?
Top marks for effort there, I thought.
Absolutely.
I mean, singing-wise, slightly, you know.
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah, I don't think the record labels are going to come knocking at the door just yet.
But in terms of stage presence and routine, loving the bauble earrings.
Yeah, got it all there. And you're going to be, you know, you're going to be gracing the fashion pages with that outfit, isn't she, really?
She's certainly, you know, in with a chance of winning the fashion competition tonight.
I think so. Good.
I absolutely loved my first year, although it did not all go to plan. There was bumps in the road, but it's made me who I am today. And I've definitely built on my self-development. So earlier on, we spoke to Bailey and he spoke to some students about their experiences in uni.
Martin, you've had many twists and turns in the last few years, but tonight you can win Students in Their Eyes 2018. And remember, if you want to crown Martin to become your Students in Their Eyes winner 2018, then all you've got to do is call the number from a landline 080 10 40 41 03. And from a mobile, the number you need to call is 540 41 03. Just to quickly remind you, votes cost 35 pence plus any network access charge. Also vote for free via the app if you don't want to pay for that one. She's been brilliant, everyone. It's Martin! We are just moments away from finding out who will be crowned the winner of Students in Their Eyes 2018. And for one last time, your Students in Their Eyes finalist 2018. Nathan Ivory. Riley Watkins. Ashley Thompson. Martin Dennis. And Connor Tullough-Wall. After 13 shows, it all comes down to this. The winner of Students in Their Eyes 2018 is...
will be revealed from this cracker. Ooh.
We ready?
We ready.
Nathan Ivory! Well, that's all from me tonight. A big thank you to our judges, our lovely audience, and of course, you at home. It's been such a memorable one, hasn't it? I'll see you again in September 2019 for another season here of Students in Their Eyes 2019. Good night.
Thank you to our amazing contestants and our amazing winners. It's unfortunate that they didn't win, but if you want to have a go, please be sure to email us and make sure that you can come on the show. And we'll be back here next week.
Of course.
Same time. Have a lovely day, guys.
Good night, guys.
Hey guys, this is the Going Into Black History Month podcast. I'm Connor.
And I'm Martin.
And we've got a great lineup for you today.
We will be playing a little game later on as well with our lovely Abby playing snippets of songs and you guys will have to guess what they are. Please do comment and tweet in some answers for in the bag to win.
And if you guess right, you'll have the chance to win a ticket for yourself and two others to see the Black Eyed Peas concert at the Barclaycard Arena this Monday.
So the first two people to get all the songs right will be in it for a chance to win, so keep your ears open.
And we've got a special guest in later, an amazing artist that we'll be able to hear from that will go through two of his tracks on two separate albums that he's made.
That's it. Our amazing special guest, Mehdi Ranks, will be opening up about his struggles in life, about living in Jamaica with his mother who did work on a plantation. We've now got our lovely Abby kicking off this game with the first song. Here we go.
Okay, so the first song is a reggae song. The title and lyrics refer to the black US cavalry regiments that fought in the Indian Wars after 1866. The title refers to them being a specific animal as well as them being a soldier.